Hey, y'all. Zach here, the legal tech advisor at Lawyerist, and I've got another product demo for you. This time, we're looking at PracticePanther, a law practice management system for small to medium-sized attorneys. And today, I'd like to show you how easily you can create a potential client intake form for your website. And when we do this, we're going to create a follow-up task and link it to a new contact. So here we are at the PracticePanther dashboard. This is where you go when you log in, essentially. And you can see that it's my dashboard. We got Zach Laser up here, and it's for the company. We have a fake Lawyerist law firm here. And you can create a new contact, new matter, new event, new task, all of these things that are, you know, you can quickly manipulate. You can also make new things just by going to here. It's a pretty usable interface. Most of our tasks, though, are up here. And so today we're going to go into automation. And there are a couple of different ways to do automations here. You can do templates for documents. You can do workflows for your tasks. You can set up payment plans. But what we're going to do is going to go into intake forms. And we're going to create an intake form for our website. So we do new intake template. And then this is going to let us drag and drop our fields in here. So we're going to grab form title. We're going to call this contact us because it's going to go on our website. We do a description and just put a very quick little disclaimer. You probably want more information than that, but we're doing this quickly. And we'll do, actually, we'll wait on that. We'll do text. So we have a first name. We'll do a last name. Again, keep it consistent. And actually, we want to make those required. And see how easy it is to go back into these. And we'll do an email address. We're not going to make this one required because some people may not want to communicate with you that way. So we'll also give them the ability to put their phone number in. Again, not required. And we'll do a single select checklist. Talk like humans instead of area of law. Let's do state plan. Add another option. And then we're going to do a multi-line text. Close that preview. Let's call this description. Nobody will ever see the word briefly because nobody ever briefly describes their issues. Okay, and that is pretty much it. So we've got first name, last name, email address, phone number, type of matter, and description. This is a very basic intake form that we can put on our website. So we go down and we give it a name, called estate planning. Don't worry about the description. And we want to create a task after the intake. So yes, and we'll assign it to me and send notification email after intake. We could do that. I don't want to in this scenario, but you could, and you could assign that to someone. So this could, the task could be assigned to an assistant, and an email could be assigned to, you know, one of the attorneys. That way, multiple people are getting informed of this. So we hit submit. And we're going to have to connect the information. We're going to have to map the data, like the information that's coming into this form. We want to put it into our database somewhere. So we're going to go here and we're going to find first name. So this information is going to go into that field in our database. Last name, same thing there. That's going to go into contact email and contact mobile number. If we had created custom fields, we could connect type of matter and description, but we don't really have anything that works there very well right now. Or if we had created a form that was going to make a new matter. So we could have an internal form for our people working with us to keep things streamlined, but we're not going to do that right now. We're just going to leave those blank. It's going to be information that comes to us, but it's not going to necessarily get input directly into the system. So what we want to do is create a new contact after the form is filled out. And we're going to assign the new records to Zach Glazer, only person that works here. We're not going to create a new matter. Again, if you had done something that was matter related, you might want to do that. And we're going to update the existing contact after the form is filled out, just in case we've put the contact in already before we send this to them. And we're not going to update the existing matter. Again, we're not dealing with the matter on this. So we're going to link the fields. So now we have a new intake. And if we drill into that, you can see that we could edit this intake and all the things that we just did. So that's simple to go in and edit it. And that sends us back into settings, which is an odd place, but that's fine. We'll just go to dashboard here. And we'll do a new intake. So click on that. We select the only intake form we have. And we could share this via email. We could also embed this intake with this iframe right here by copying that and pasting it into the back end of our website if we were using WordPress or Wix or Squarespace or something like that. But we're just going to go to share, hit continue. And this is where your client would wind up if you sent them the link. This is just a place to get this. And if you had embedded this on your website, it would just be this information right here. So we're going to fill this out. We're going to say Stan Laurel, Stan at example.com. Obviously a fake number. We're going to do some litigation here and I want to sue my brother. I don't know if Stan Laurel had a brother. Say that we're not a robot, and then submit. So as you can see, I now have a new notification. This notification, we click on it and it takes me to Stan Laurel's page where we've got an intake right here. So we could get to this information through that notification. This obviously created a new client or new contact rather. And then I can follow up with this person. Their mobile number has come in automatically. The email has come in automatically. And then we can move forward. More importantly though, if we go to activities here, say that came in at night and we just jump into activities to see what we have to do today. And we go, we see we have the new client intake estate planning. This was just created. Click on that. And it takes us to that task page. And it says that we need to follow up on this client intake. So we drill into there. We go look at this information. And that's the intake that we want to follow up on. So here we want to say, we want to see that, okay, it's a state litigation and there's the description because that information didn't come in with us. So we get back out of there. We go to Stan Laurel. And we can put a note in or something like that. But we also have our intakes right here. So I could get to that document right there. And this is just a bunch of different ways to get to kind of the same thing. I could go back. And we're back on Stan Laurel's thing. And we see that we could get to the activity this way as well. So I want to go to this activity because I want to clear it. And we want to say completed. So now that's completed. We go back to this guy and we have done our intake here. So that's not all that PracticePanther can do. As you could probably glean from a lot of this, you can keep track of a lot of information with PracticePanther. They're good at accounting. They're good for small to medium sized attorneys. They have a good deal of integrations. They have a decent bit of automation. But hopefully this was helpful for you. Hopefully you learned something. And I will see you next time around the Lawyerist ecosystem.